do this. Hi, my name is Hannah Pamonte, and I'm the artist in residence for Spokane Art School. This is Kinsley Grapes, and today we are going to show you how to make
homemade Play-Doh.
Okay, what you're going to need is we have some flour. So we have 2 cups of flour. Then we also have a cup of salt.
Remember, there was a big cup and I just dropped it in.
Yeah, I do remember that. Then we also have 2 cups of water, and then we need 2 teaspoons of cream of tartar, and then 2 tablespoons of oil. So Kinsley and I are going to get started. The first thing that we're going to do is put in our flour. So do you want to pour that in?
This one?
Yep. So you can dump that in our big bowl. So there's 2 cups of flour. Good job, Kins. Do you want to add our cup of salt?
Right here?
Yep. So there's 1 cup of salt. Good job. And then we can add in our Kool-Aid. Do you want to add in our Kool-Aid?
Yes.
Let's add our Kool-Aid in. Yeah, so we'll dump in the whole packet. Yeah, get it nice and then there. Do you need some help? Good job, Kins. And then what we might do is add a few drops of food dye just to make it more vibrant in its color. Then what we want to do is add our cream of tartar, which we need 2 teaspoons of that.
Right here?
Yep, that's it.
The sprinkling one or just the dumping one?
Let's do the dumping one. I think that'd make it easier. Do you need help? Oh, there we go. Okay.
Can I dump it in?
Yep. So there's our first teaspoon. Beautiful. Okay, then we have to add our 2 tablespoons of oil. So do you want to dump that in there? Nice. Okay.
It's dripping.
That's okay. And then do you want to add in our 2 cups of water?
Yeah.
Oops. There we go. Good job.
Now it's more grayish.
That's okay. We'll add a little more tablespoons. So she's going to get a paper towel, and then our next step is just to mix it all together, and then we're going to put it over the stove so we can heat it up so we can get that nice Play-Doh consistency. So we will show you how to do that next. So then Kinsley and I are just going to add a few drops of food dye to make it a little more vibrant in its color.
And more purplish, because we're making purple this time. Mm-hmm. And it's more, the water is more grayish than
water. But it smells really good, doesn't it?
Smells like grape.
Okay, just a few drops.
How many?
1, 2. Let's do 4. Okay, that's good.
Let's do 1 more.
That was a big drop. Put the lid on there.
That, when you drop it in, it looks like black, but it's actually purple.
Mm-hmm. And do you know why that is?
Because it's food.
Food dye. So the pigment's super condensed, and then we mix it in, and then it disperses that color throughout. So like I said before, we're just mixing this in, and then what we do is we put it on the stove over medium and we stir that until it gets a little thicker in its consistency, and then we're going to knead it out, and then we have Play-Doh. So now Kinsley and I are going to add in our Play-Doh into our pan, which we have at medium heat right now. Then Kinsley's going to help stir it.
And then when you put it in, it might look a little more gray because we only put like 4 drops in it.
So what Kinsley's saying is that while we're stirring it, we might add a few more drops of food dye to make it really, really purple. So dumping that in. What do you hear that sizzle?
What does that mean?
It means it's cooking. Our Play-Doh is cooking.
It only cooks for a few minutes, and then you put the dye in, but not when it's done cooking.
So you only have to mix it for a few minutes, and then what happens is it starts to thicken, and it kind of shifts in color a little bit, and then you know your Play-Doh's done. So Kinsley's going to add a few more drops of the food dye. Nice. Good job, Kinsley. Yeah.
Okay. It's going to be super dark.
Now Kinsley is stirring, and it's starting to get thicker, isn't it?
Hard.
So that means it's starting to become its more Play-Doh consistency.
Do you want me
to stir it?
Yeah, I want you to stir it. Okay. You can put it back.
Okay, so now our Play-Doh is getting nice and thick, which means that we are going to need to knead it next. Isn't that right, Kins?
Yeah. So she's just going to knead it right now.
Is it even on right now, Kins?
Yes.
Oh, we'll go show them how to knead it in the other room.
Hot.
Okay, so the next step is to knead our Play-Doh.
See how purple it is when you when you're done cooking it?
So do you want to explain to them what I'm doing right now?
She's just kneading right now. And then we're going to show you how to make shapes out of cookie cutters. And then we're going to roll it out to make the cookie shapes.
Yep.
Smells good.
So Kinsley's going to roll out our Play-Doh and we are going to do activity number one.
Can you roll it out?
Yeah, you want me to do it? Now, the first activity that you can do is take cookie cutters and cut out shapes. So, Kinsley's going to show you how to do that. Ooh, a tree, my favorite. Okay, so there's a diamond.
Pokey.
That's a lot of pokies.
But it has one side, two sides, three sides, four sides.
Sticky. Let's do this. So something you can do is take the shape of animals or toys and actually just press them in and then watch the impression that it makes. So then Kinsley is making footprints and now we have a guest visitor, Maddie. Hey Maddie. She wants to eat her Play-Doh. So then another thing that you can do with Play-Doh is also use it as kind of like a modeling clay and make sculptures. Okay, so Kinsley is gonna show you guys how to make a snake. I'll show you how to do a butterfly.
So right now you just like roll it out into like a, how long you want it to be. If you want it to be really long, you can roll it really long. If you want it to just be medium, you can just roll it medium. You could always squish it and then roll it again.
Mm-hmm. That's the magic of Play-Doh.
Here's my snake.
That was really good. There's the butterfly. And then I think Kinsley and I are now just going to play on our own time, make some other animal shapes. But
we might not have enough Play-Doh for it.
Yeah, that's true.
So we might have to...
Do you want to sit down?
We might have to like squish some animals and then... But it's okay if you squish some animals because if you want to redo them, you can redo them.
Yep, that is true. Kinsley and I just wanted to say thank you for watching. We also wanted to thank Washington Trust Bank for sponsoring this video. And Kinsley and I will see you next time. So thanks for watching.
Bye. What is this? A duck?
Like, I think it's like a goat.
A cow? Looks like a cow because the chin.
Maybe it's a cow. Yeah.